All right, okay. So I'm going to go back to suffrage, because, oh my gosh, I smile for it. Suffrage, human suffrage. We start with human suffrage and just all focus on that body, physical, and yes, you're born with these particular elements of physical, blood, bones, flesh, and brain, and that's it. That's your party, and it's over, and it's nothing in conclusion with anything else elemental. No rocks, no aura, no nothing is part of that event. And we already know that that is wrong. We know this is wrong. We are affected by the elements as we intake into our body. We are affected by them so much so. Oh my gosh, I had this weird, odd, gosh, I'm happy to even be small and reduced in this, even though it may make me fat face later. It is funny, I have a reduction on it. Oh my gosh, I have been eating spaghetti and leaving that water in just because I'm leaving the water in. I need to get warmer or something. So yeah, suffrage. My gosh, what a beast! So we're talking about this world of looser inhibitions, unbelievable. And I'm thinking, if we look at the food supply, if you don't want to say you are a talking rock, a series of talking rocks that are reorganizing within your brain again and again and again. If you do not want to say that you are these things, if you don't want to say that you're a compellent of all of these minerals that are just reacting and creating a personality and creating who you are inside. If you don't want to say that, well, I don't know how you can go from there, because it seems like that is the process. This is our food supply. That's one of the major incomings. So there we are with this time frame, and we look at the 50s, and everybody's there, and maybe they had a few girls that were not so decadent, and then things are going more and more and more and more. Well, this past 100 years, I'll say so, with the it's just become excessive. And I'm thinking, okay, we have more and more imports, don't we? More and more imports. We are eating food from all over the planet. We're eating food from oh my gosh, I'm eating food from all over the planet, you know. And so because we have this food sources from everywhere, we are also taking in similarities that are cultural. You go to different areas of the world, certain persons are acting certain ways again and again and again. And you cannot say that their personalities are not affected by their food and the soils and minerals that they are gaining from that food. So there's their personality from that saturation of not eating from imported foods, but only from a locality source. So they're eating from a locality source. And when they're from the locality source, it does hinder quite a bit, doesn't it? It keeps the person in a kind of a Calvinist. You can run back to the Calvinist state and say you can actually see how time in the past 2,000 years with the increase of religions, you can see how easy it was to keep people in their Amish or their Calvinistic aspects. Because this is it. This is the only food supply, and this is what we eat. And it's just part of us. But as soon as you start importing wilder persons, food from wilder persons, and yes, it is wilder persons also, because they degrade back into the body earth of the planet, and we eat them again. You know, it's all part of this recycle process. So eventually they do become the minerals that freshen back into the foods. So here we have this one group over there, and they're really wild and crazy, like just loud and rambunctious. And so you cannot say that all of a sudden you're eating or drinking these teas from, you have a tea import. You cannot say that all of a sudden your personality is not affected. It could very well be affected directly by this rambunctious group that has just gone completely wild for years and years and years and years, and that's just their normal. So when we have all of this going on, when we have importation here, and we have importation here, and importation here, and then back again to them, back to that original rambunctious group, we will lose that rambunctious place, won't we? So it does start to become almost over mellow yellow. We will lose that rambunctious group, that original rambunctious group, where they only ate and drank from that carriage of stones, that locality, location. The more import, the more that we are dragging and dredging and then trading back and forth and saying, no, 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 this one, and you can have this one, and I can have that bit of candy or whatever of food, you know, and because that looks so delicious, what you're making. And then over here, this looks delicious also. As more of this continues, we are going to lose this personality of dramatic rambunctiousness. We are going to go back over here to what if there was a Calvinist state of persons that only ate from that locality. Those persons will, in their timidities and their religious and their re-eating of that particular harvest, they are not going to be the same either. They're going to start eating their foods and vice versa. So when this is happening, we have a oh my gosh, yeah, we start to see, are we going to become just incredibly mellow? And look back at this particular time frame, even now here talking out here on this internet, and look back and go, oh my gosh, what a bunch of wild ones, what a bunch of aggressives, unbelievable. We're all passive now, you know, we're all passive. We've found come some kind of a standardization self, standardization. Yeah, so global mix-up there. Do we want to be this type of person also? I there was one woman, She told me once that she worked at the U.S. government, and she worked in the food department, and that was her main deal, was locality foods. She kept saying, we have to eat only locality foods. She was really, really stern with this. And I'm like, okay, locality food, I understand, it's not imported, doesn't hurt the planet, okay. And that's where I was taking it from, in initially was not to hurt the planet, you know, with the additional transportations and the cargo ships and all of this. But as more and more I'm thinking of it, it was not only this, it was actually much further, and how it affects the mind. So do we want to be, if we look at the, I can run and be ridiculous and say the heathen group of Malaysia. Is that Malaysia there? Those types of cities where they just get rid of they just have their daughters and they're like, oh yes, there's a daughter, and we sell her off into prostitution immediately when she's 10 or 11 years old. We can look at that group as we are now eating from those particular soils. So what does that mean for us? What does that mean as a decision? Does that bring us less compassion when we see a child, a prostitute, young, run away on the street? Most likely, yes. It's affecting our opinion. Was I eating from Malaysia there? Something, possibly some rice was imported. Maybe I got a bag of rice and I ate that for a year. And so now I'm like, well, I really don't care. if she is a prostitute and she is 10 or 11 years old. So that's what I'm trying to impart with this particular concept of, yeah, the edible personality there. Who are we? Who are we and from where? I do feel different. I do feel different. Certainties from certain localities. I do feel different. It is a strange one also when you're looking at the British specifically as a group and this push over their tea. This drastic tea, they have to have this tea, and it has to be from India. It has to be specifically from India. So it has affected them as persons to only be drinking this tea for, what, 200-300 years straight. Wonder what they would be like if they did not have that tea. They get really cranky for it too, like addicts. They didn't have it. They didn't have that tea in the shop. Oh my gosh, they didn't have the tea in the shop. They are absolutely addicted to this tea. And they call it, I don't know, what do they call it? Legends of Greystoke or tea? The Grey, Earl Grey. What is the other? They have, oh my gosh, them and their breakfast teas and all of this is just like, you have to have it. What is it? Is it like, what is it? Is it like some strange joke to them that you did not drink the tea? It's very odd. They get put out. You didn't drink the tea. You went straight for the coffee. You wanted juice, you wanted a smoothie, you wanted some green chloral drink or something. What? Spirulina? You didn't drink the tea from India. Yeah, it's an odd repetitional, and you keep putting that into a group of population. And I start to see them as such a generalist anyway. And so there they are, the Americans on the other side. We talk to the Americans. Yeah, the Americans over there, and they are drinking that watered-down, nasty cowboy coffee. And oh my gosh, it is watered down, and it's just like re-cranked through, and the waitress keeps showing up again and again and again. And she's on this refeed of the drink, and she just has to keep pouring this drink in, and it's just like continually. So you end up with like 6 or 7 cups of coffee just to like wake up. I'm like at the very first time in this moment of my life, I'm ever witnessing it. I'm going, this is wrong. This is inherently wrong. Anything that needs this many refills is wrong. There is something missing. Yeah. Hugely. Like, how may we disconcentrate you? And how may we take your focus and your energy and just keep being an interruptus and being an interruptus and being an interruptus and clang, clang, clang with all of these plates in the room? Let's be another interruptus. And they call this socialization. How may I interrupt you? not talking about suffering today, but some person is not to receive this particular cup of this cowboy coffee, or their Starbucks, or their beautiful Pete's blend. Oh my gosh, and not have the filters, and not have it all correct and not perfect, you know what I'm saying? Oh my gosh, so for some that is a life that is just a sad, sad morning, it's a sad day, and I have been there. I have been there on that addict trail. I've woken up that morning after we lost our business, we lost the three, we only had three servers that were outside of Vario. We only had three, and that he wrote out. He wrote the whole Vario system by himself on his own, because we just needed to get more money. We were broke, and so he wrote his own version. And when we lost those three, we kind of had nervous breakdowns, and they moved them. It was the Digital Nation. They moved them from, I don't know. They move them state to state to another state, and by the third state move, I don't know, I guess we freaked out. And meanwhile, I was not getting coffee in the morning, and I'm in the hotel room, I'm freaking the hell out. I lost my entire business, everything, all these years is gone, and I didn't have the gosh damn coffee. I didn't care if the liver died at that moment. I just, God damn it, where the hell is its coffee? It becomes like this focus hall, you know, it's just this focus hall over this one drink. One drink. And I have to have that drink. Eventually I found a coffee shop. Had to wait though, I had to wait like, I don't know, 3 hours or something, and I don't know. Take a walk in the traffic in the Florida, in the Florida heat swamp. I had to take a walk. Yeah, and the coffee shop didn't open. It wasn't even open in the morning. It was like, what is this going on? You know, it's like, how could this even be possible? The only place in the town that was available with the coffee was not even open in the morning when I was needing it. Just awful, an awful experience. For some reason, the hotel did not have it either. It only had prostitutes. Yeah, that's the money we made there in the old virtual servers. We could stay at prostitute special hotels. Yeah. Sorry about that. I guess I needed the money. I guess I pushed him. We needed the money. I guess so. It's always about paying off the stupid houses. Paying off houses. Just living this suffrage of trying to pay off a stupid house. Rent a house, pay it that way, whatever. I don't know. Where was I going with this video? My coffee freak out. Yeah, that's a tough one. It's a tough one. On the lurking mornings when you know you have the plausibility to go there, to go that far, and to grit in till nothing else matters except that damn cup of coffee. When you are gritting in, You don't care about anything. I'm like, how could there be such an addict to some source of beans? How is this possible? I guess because my life was so awful with knowing the flounce about that exists, the flounce about that exists and is available to exist again and again and again, and knowing that I'm not on that particular tree, for some reason I have been denied that tree, that particular suffrage of disallow, because I'm not allowed on that particular tree, and all of these flouncies are on it, and they are just ingredients that are just given and given and given. Perhaps that is why the symbol of the coffee denouncing. Perhaps that is why I freak so far on it. It's interesting though that one video, I don't want to over mention her name or anything, because I'm not a followant personality of another, but she is involved in the PETA sort of personality with ecology. And I will say it is a loud one. She has a loud one, and this Sylvie Guillaume. And that, I'm shocked by it. I'm shocked that this would be her direction, energy, because we know this. We already know this. We've been, go out there and do it, whatever. Go out there and do it. I don't think it's the answer. I don't think going out there with the ships, trying to stop them directly, is the answer. I don't think this is working. It's like at this point, it's like throwing stones into an ocean so vast and deep it never feels the ripple. For people that are going to their food supply, and they will eat it out until there is nothing left. They don't have the brains or foresight to think past. You can't expect them to change. The only way to have those persons change is to change their food source. All of a sudden, this is what we are eating today. This is what's available at the store on for sale. You're talking to an illiterate group of persons. They will only eat what they have been eating for years, what their mother has eaten for years, what their grandfather, etc., and so on. Why would they? Why would they know any different? They're not going to run out to your Albertsons or whatever and get a lettuce that has the roots growing, and get all excited and plant it in the back garden and pluck at the leaves and then go and make a salad. They're not those types of persons. So, yeah, now they're eating from the immature fish. So that's even worse. So the main thing now, we're looking at them as a population. You want to look at them as a population to stop their suffrage from increasing, because they suffer. They see the glam on TV. They're suffering to see the glam on TV. They're suffering so much that they really don't care if we live or die. Maybe take the glam off TV. Don't put it down in those particular regions of the world. Don't allow it relaying into impoverished nations. So yeah. just saying, you can't change the persons in the middle of the, while they're making their recipe cake, you cannot change them in the middle. You actually have to change the ingredients of the cake. They'll still keep making the recipe. You just need to change the ingredients available. Now we already know they're, what do they call them? I call them the Mexicans, but they're called the Mexican Americans. And sometimes they're just called the Mexicans back again, and sometimes Hispanic. Other times they just call them, oh yeah, Spanish descent. The other times they call them mulatto Mexicans. They call them indigenous Mexicalis. They are a tedious bunch. Which one are you? Well, anyway, persons from that particular area. My gosh, what's the deal with them? I don't know, I've got the cat wondering. Yeah, they're also getting that hyped in television. And they play that specific though, they've played that specifically, that let's make a middle class, or attempt to. It does exist there. There are all those big stores. They have the Walmarts. They have all of those big stores there. You can actually go right there to big Walmarts and buy your beautiful bikini if you need it. So there is no reason for them to travel to the United States to live. Is back to that middle class zone, though. They have to, they see these glamour TV shows, and the glamour TV shows make them want to travel to make more money, want to travel and make more money. Just be like Americans, be like Americans. And I'm not even gonna say be like British, because the British are still drinking that tea. And that tea does keep them more islandish. They get their 2 weeks holiday, they're happy with it, and they will go back to their tea. Americans are different, though. Now, why the Americans are different? More into world politics. World politics for change. I am not seeing world politics for change coming out of Britain. Oh, I'm angry today. This is fun, so I'm going to have my tiny resolution, and now I'm going to be yowl back in here looking at why did I paint the sheep that color. I'm not sure, it's the wrong color. I don't know, I'm enjoying this though for the moment. Suffrage, what is suffrage? I don't know. Some person just says my nose is running. Oh my gosh, sorry, I hate that. Oh my gosh. Yeah, so I'm only eating starches now. I mean, on a starch and apples. And so what is this, the pure carb diet? Yeah, pure carbs here. No, sometimes I don't know. It's okay, I'm doing all right, actually. I'm not fretted into society's needs at the moment. But it does not mean I want to live as a shantytown woman, because that would be wrong. That would be a wrong. That would be too far a downgrade. Too far a downgrade. And the problem is with her, if these shantytown women are looking at that TV set, they're looking at that TV set and they're getting these stupid little opulent shows like Survive on This Island, or what is it, to date this person, and oh my gosh, and here's all these young girls, teenage, what do you call them, Big Brother shows and all of that. Yeah, so all of this is going on. They're just getting like, what? So they're starting to feel deprived. So the true suffrage in their particular hearts and their minds starts coming in into the impoverished suffrage state because they've seen television, because they know these stupid shows. So why would we bring them additional suffrage? They're already living in a particular groupage of not a lot of money, not a lot of housing, and they don't. Why do they need to know about these massive building supply centers? Why do they need to know about the way Americans build their houses and change their curtains again and again? Why do they need to know this? Why do we have to have this exactation everywhere, right now? It's way too forceful. We cannot have that. You're expecting every single economy in the world to change and adapt and be as you immediately. As soon as they see that TV set that is having these glamoration shows, even these stupid talk shows of The View or whatever, or some stupid soap opera. So yeah, that's what I was thinking about when their suffrage begins. The remote control clicked on, changing the channel. Gosh dang it, everything is just gross in my head, what the heck. Alright, so what? When does suffrage begin? Well, apparently, in my particular case, I'm gonna say it for the judge, the jury. In my case, suffering began right away. Right away, my mother was completely disappointed that I was female. Completely disappointed. I was one of those. I was trying to be the breech, and so they flipped, the doctor flipped me, flipped me before the birth. She was complete, I was an easy birth, but she was disappointed that I was female, because a red-headed little girl, the chances are I guess there was a cartoon character at the time, and that cartoon character was not attractive. Some little iodine, I think they called her, which is interesting now in this day and stage, little iodine, yeah. So she's like, oh no, she's gonna look like the little iodine. So whoever this little iodine is must have been horrible, but that was a, like, her first motherly warm words to me. So, I guess suffrage could begin right there. or the disappoints. Probably before, though, if I was already flipped out on, I'm not going out there, I'll just, no, I don't want to go out there. Yeah, that was lucky. The doctor just flipped right from the stomach. He rotated me from the stomach. So, yeah. What else I was talking of? Well, yeah, I guess so. Endless, isn't it? It seems like it's an endless. Perhaps that's our only real, I hate to use goal, also it's so sports oriented. And that's a ruin. I can't use that word. What's another word for goal? Is there another word for goal? Perhaps that's our some kind of a. There seems to be nothing more right now. So it is going to be the what? The removal of it, not having it anymore. That is going to be the release of it. Release of it, but yet also knowing to not ever go back into it again. So there has to be you have to have acknowledgement of the suffering, or you've learned nothing from all of the suffering from before. You cannot just wipe out suffering. It exists or existed. So I think the goal is to actually have it go away forever. But yet we still are gonna have to drag it around with us, aren't we? Have to drag suffering with. Acknowledgement of it, not to drag it, you know, in persona space necessarily, but acknowledgement that it has existed. Yeah. So I don't know, that's all fine and dandy for me to be speaking of it, because I'm an understanding of it, but wow, there's a big population out there that is not even getting it. It's just the selfish gene, like major selfish gene. My life, it's my life, you know. There was that song, "It's My Life." My life, I will eat what I want, I will do what I want, I will buy what I want. These types of persons. I mean, in a way, when you are these types of persons, that means you don't heed any acknowledgement of science discoveries. You don't heed any acknowledgement of what other persons have to say or relay. So it is like living in your own little time capsule, isn't it? Your own little time capsule of experience that is only for you, only for you. Yeah. So it's quite a selfish little gobbler, isn't it? Only for me. Well, I don't know. Yeah, like yesterday, I think I was on one of these. I was talking a lot of the alone. And I'm not this melodramatic, I'm not alone. Actually, not at all. I'm not disenjoying it. It's just the state feminine, female without a partner. That is the problem. That is the problem, I believe, with a lone woman. And the whole thing with the partner from the past used to be such I guess the men need their own space, the women need their own space more and more. And I don't know where that's going either. Sometimes I do yearn for that old time when it is clummy, I guess you call it clummy, less independent. Because with all of that, what do we call it? I'm gonna call it when you get all of that independent female or independent male, what do you get? You're not gonna get your food baked or cooked for you. You're not getting food baked or cooked for you because they're also independent. So who are you actually living with? You know, you're living with the sexual partner. After a while, it's a purely, merely a sexual experience. And so then, yeah, like, that's not so cool. It'd only just be the sex. And then, oh my gosh, and then what is this? The independent female, independent woman is like, no, I don't want to be her anymore. I want to be the other one. I want to be dependent. I want to be the dependent, clingy one. And so now I'll just get out my sabers and sword immediately and reject all other females and put them in a place of, yes, I'm uproarious in jealousy. And I will pursue, and I will go after any woman who dares to look upon him. Dares. Anyway, funny. I'll see. I'm just gonna see if this resolution. I'm gonna stop it now. I don't know. I'm not sure where I'm going with this talking. If I'm making any sense today. Anyway.